So when learning a new programming language, do you need to pick a course that actually teaches you how to create a gigantic application like Facebook? Or is it better to actually pick a course that teaches you or focuses more on teaching you the fundamentals? Let's talk about the differences between the two approaches in today's video. This video is brought to you by the Learn Programming Academy's Beginning C Programming course. With 23 hours of video training contained in the course, you really can add the C programming language to your resume quickly and without fuss. Grab a massive discount and instant access by visiting lpa.dev/YouTubeC or by clicking on the link in the description of this video. Welcome back. My name is Tim Buchalka with another programming tip of the day. And we're talking about courses that actually have a huge app that they build versus a course that doesn't have a specific app but more focuses on smaller apps. Now, there is a reason for me coming up with this video, and that's based on questions that I often get from students who are basically looking for courses that teach you how to create the next Facebook. So they basically want a course that teaches them how to create a bit of code like that. Well, firstly, creating a huge app like that isn't practical. Now, the reason is that Facebook and applications of that nature have probably had hundreds, if not thousands, of developers working on them and thousands or tens of thousands of man years to evolve to the point where they're at now. So it isn't practical to learn that from scratch as a beginning programmer. Now, you may not know that because you're new to programming, and that's fine, but the reality is if you're looking for a course to teach you how to create an app of that nature in one course, it's not going to happen. You need to build your skills up first and foremost. This is the important thing. Learn your skills first, and then from there, sure, you can start creating that course and building up to that. But look, these things take time. If every person was able to go through and do one course and create the next Facebook, then we'd have tens of thousands of versions of Facebook. The reality is that that's not really possible to do. It's very hard, at least, to do. Nothing's impossible, but it's very improbable that you're able to do that. Personally, and this is the way I focus my courses, is I teach how things work under the hood. And I actually teach how to do something so that if you go right through the course, by the end of the course, you'll have learnt all the concepts to put the big application together. So I don't actually show you how to create the big application because it's more important for you to understand the technology, understand how to put these things together, understand the building blocks to put these big applications together. Now, the other thing to check out, though, also being completely blunt here, with a lot of courses, you'll find that the ones that do say that you're going to create a WhatsApp or a Facebook or a Twitter, and they actually suggest perhaps in the description that that's the type of app that you're going to build, you find that the version you create in the course, because I've already mentioned it takes so long to create an application like that, isn't going to be what you thought it was anyway. It's going to be a really cut down, feature empty version of an app, I should say. So I'll have very few, really small amounts of functionality, and it won't be really useful to learn. So I think when you're learning, and it's whether it's my courses or any other courses, make sure that you pick a course that teaches you the programming languages and the technology. That's where you should be focusing your skills. Don't get caught up in the marketing spin of which app is going to be created in a particular course or an ebook. Focus on learning the technology. Once you understand the technology, you're then able to apply that technology. And look, you can then go ahead and create the next big Facebook or whatever you're trying to do. But bottom line is, before I end the video, learn the core skills first, learn how things work under the hood, and then you'd be skilled up and able to create your own next version of WhatsApp or Facebook. Alrighty, so I hope that helped. If you've got any questions, feel free to leave a comment and I'll get back to you. If you're ready to look at the next tip, click on up here and you can check that out. If you're interested in coding specific programming videos, click on the link in the bottom left-hand corner. Consider subscribing by clicking on the link up here, and I'll see you soon.